ChatGPT is the most advanced AI now. It is like our personal assistant. You can ask ChatGPT almost everything, and it will answer you in just a few seconds. Programmers are asking ChatGPT to write codes for them. Students are asking ChatGPT to write essay. Lawyers are asking ChatGPT to draft legal document. AI can create amazing images for you, or even comic books. AI is helping us driving our car. AI is helping us vacuum our house. Scientists and engineers are working on AI technologies to improve medicine based on our genetics, to make government more responsive and feel more like a concierge to citizens. AI is great, right? Why do we need to worry?
Mark my words, AI is far more dangerous than nukes.
The CEO of Tesla and SpaceX, the most famous CEO in the world who's transforming space travel and electric cars, thinks AI is our biggest threat. Why did he say that? How can we survive the AI era? This brings us to the concept of artificial general intelligence, or AGI. AGI will be able to perform any intellectual tasks that humans can, and it will be smarter than humans in almost every way. AGI has the potential of manipulating humans, turning against humans, or even taking over the world. If you want to know more how AI could take over the world, please watch my last YouTube video on Will AI Take Over the World? The godfather of AI, Geoffrey Hinton, who just quits Google, thinks AI will outsmart us in 5 to 20 years. That's closer than we think, folks. Pause AI development, but if AI could be a threat, why don't we just hit the pause button? Good question, but it's not as simple as it sounds. The problem is we can't expect everyone to stop, can we? If one company stops, others will continue. For example, if OpenAI pauses ChatGPT's development, companies like Google, Facebook, or Baidu will continue. If one country stops, others won't. So it's impossible to pause AI. Risks of AGI. So we have this super smart AGI on the horizon, and we can't just hit pause. What does that mean for us? Let's talk about three risks that are more related to you and how you can survive in this AI era. Will AI steal our jobs? Today, we know ChatGPT can write articles faster than journalists. AI systems are also getting better at writing code. AI is also taking on tasks from legal assistants, such as doing research or reviewing contracts. Sure, they make errors and need our supervision, but they are capable of completing tasks that previously took days within hours or even minutes. That's why they're likely to soon become standard tools used by everyone in their daily work. So, if a job can be done by human and cost $1,000, if AI can do it faster and cost only $100 or cheaper, then AI will make a lot of jobs disappear in the future. Does this mean you'll lose your job? Maybe, maybe not. Many people are afraid of AI, so they try to stay away from AI. But AI is probably one of the most powerful tools that we have ever invented. If you don't use these tools, then you cannot really compete with other people who are using the AI tools, and you will likely to lose your job. Learn to work with AI. To avoid this, we need to first learn to work with AI. As AI gets smarter and more common, it's super important we figure out how to work well with it. For example, there's a scientific field studying the structure of proteins. There are about 100 to 200 million proteins on Earth. Our scientists have only managed to find less than 1% of the them. However, an AI program, AlphaFold, which is developed by Google's subsidiary, has predicted the structure of almost all the proteins on Earth in just 2 years. So if a job can be done faster by AI, then let AI do it. We focus on the things that AI is not good at. For example, after discovering all the proteins, we can focus on creating things that is useful to humans. By mixing our creativity with AI's data skills, we can come up with totally new solutions to tough problems. Second, learn to communicate with AI. Many of you may have used ChatGPT before. Did you know by asking ChatGPT in different ways, you can get very different results? The better you ask, the better you get. The difference can be like night and day. Because of this, there are a bunch of online courses popping up, teaching how to ask ChatGPT just the right way. They're even calling it prompt engineering. Third, embrace lifelong learning and adaptability. In the AI era, it's super important to keep learning and adjusting if you want to stay ahead. Things change fast, so it's key to stay in the loop with the latest tech and job market trends. By always learning new stuff, you'll make sure your skills stay fresh and you don't get left behind. The second risk is misinformation. AI is capable of producing convincing fake content. This raises more concerns about how AI will transform our society in negative ways. Take a look at these photos of the Pope, apparently wearing a white puffer jacket. They look pretty real, don't they? How about this one? Trump being arrested by police. They're as fake as a $3 bill. all created using AI. If you think they are incredibly real, how about this one?
You guys cool if I play some sports?
How can we tell what is real and what is fake? It is very difficult. Rise of misinformation. These photos and video were created using AI image generators. These illustrate how AI technology is making it easier and cheaper than ever to create fake content. Many worried that this could supercharge a phenomenon that's already one of the most significant threats to us, misinformation. There's been talk about mass producing misinformation online. This is currently mainly done manually. Large numbers of people in so-called troll factories that produce misinformation and intervene in online conversations on social media and elsewhere. When this can be automated on a massive scale, this will create even much bigger concerns. We're very late in figuring out what to do about social media fake news. This has hurt our society with so much polarization and hostility. In the AI era, things are moving so fast with much larger scale, we shouldn't wait it any longer to act. To regulate this, government can play a key role. Government needs to make AI-created content perfectly clear to the audience. For example, all AI-generated information must be marked as generated by AI. Okay, the bad guys will break the law for sure, so we need to invent new AI tools to fight misinformation, like how we have fought spam and cyber warfare. AI companies also have a responsibility to ensure their systems do not contribute to the spread of misinformation. This requires them to think deeply about the ethical consequences of their work. They have to take into account the potential misuse of their technology and proactively build in safeguards to prevent it. We, as the recipients of the information, need to become more savvy internet users. We need to learn how to spot the good stuff, the real and reliable information among all the noise. We need to get into the habit of checking things twice or even three times from different places before believing what we read. AI takes over the world. This isn't just a sci-fi movie plot, folks. If AI were to take over, it wouldn't just affect one country or one group of people. It would be a problem for everyone everywhere. Think about it like a worldwide nuclear war. It doesn't matter where you live. The consequences would be devastating for all of us. To manage this, we might need to set up a global system, similar to the one we have for overseeing nuclear energy, like the International Atomic Energy Authority. We need the world to come together, acknowledge this challenge, and tackle it together, just as we have done for other global threats. Yes, AI brings incredible possibilities, but it also presents real challenges. As we move forward into this AI era, it's crucial we develop AI responsibly and ethically. On an individual level, it's about learning to adapt and collaborate with AI. Remember, the one will replace you is not AI, but the one using AI. So embrace AI, learn what it can do for you. Above all, let's remember to maintain a positive attitude and mutual respect, not just for each other, but for our AI counterparts as well. Thanks for sticking with us to the end. If you like this video, please hit the like button, subscribe, and comment on what you think of AI. See you in the next one.